We know that food systems are charged with delivering food to their populations every day, affordably, availably, and safely. What we see will be two big trends, one in the developed world and one in the developing world. In the developed world, we know that there is a huge demand for sustainably produced goods. People want to know not just what is in their food, but they want to know that it's sustainably produced and that people, planet, and profit considerations have been taken into account. In the developed world, we know that there still is a relatively long way to go in terms of nutritional information and education. People have access to also a very limited range of choices for food, and they need to understand how to expand that and how to provide a wider dietary range for their family on a daily basis. These two trends we'll see continuing to 2030. Through history, we know that getting the right policies in place has been critical to trends such as the Green Revolution and people's access to food available at the price they can afford. Moving forward, we know that this policy agenda has to be done within the SDG framework. So the pressure is on not to just look at the economics of the situation, but to look at the social and environmental impact. We know that there's the challenge now of having all policies being cross-cutting. This gives a huge mandate for coordination. It's going to call for a higher level of coordination between nutrition agencies, government import, food import companies, public-private partnerships. We know that new channels and new areas of cooperation will need to emerge to make this happen.